The covenant of marriage was established by God, who created us, male and female, for each other. With his presence and power, Jesus graced a wedding at Cana of Galilee, and in his sacrificial love gave us the example of the love for husband and wife. Kyle and Olivia come to give themselves to one another in this holy covenant.
Love is patient, love is kind. It always protects, it always trusts, it always hopes, and it always preserves. Love never fails. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and the love. But the greatest of all of these is love.
The marriage of Kyle and Olivia unites their families, and it creates a new one.
Two are better than one because they have a good return for their hard work. If either should fall, one can pick up the other. Also, if two lie down together, they can stay warm. But how can anyone stay warm alone? Also, one can be overpowered, but two together can put up resistance.
Well, God created man. God said, you know, it's not good that man should be alone. God created you two. And that should you follow God in your marriage, you'll see just the power of what it means when God says, this is good. Because I'm sure that as you join together today in marriage, God is saying, this is very good. For two are better than one. Olivia, you may seal this covenant with a kiss.
Come away with me. Come away with me.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my joy and honor to present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Bratke, and Kyle, and Olivia.
Wake up with the rain falling on a tin roof while I'm safe there in your arms. So all I ask is for you to come away with me in the night. Come away with me.
When your legs don't work like they used to before, and I can't sweep you off of your feet, your mouth, so remember the taste of my love. Will your eyes still smile from your cheek? Darling, I will be loving you till we're 70. I know you will still love me the same.